Cable 10 is not responsible for the content or views expressed by the participants in this program.
Welcome to Waynesville with your most excellent host, Wayne Crumbaugh.
Party! Party hardy! Welcome to Wayne's World. It's a Friday night. It's about 7 o'clock. It's time to party. I'm your excellent host, Wayne Crumbaugh. With me, as always, is Girth.
Party on, Wayne.
Party on, Girth.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Excellent. All right, before we get to the matter at hand, unnecessary strobe!
Ah! 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 Ah!
Oh, all right.
Great strobe.
Excellent. Great. Strobe. Excellent.
Cool.
Okay, now... Cool. The reason we're here today is to pay tribute to the Paul Revere Softball League.
Paul Revere? I know Paul Revere. He was the guy who rode on his horse and yelled, "The British are here, the British are here," right?
Don't be such a tool, Girth.
What?
Actually, that was Joan of Arc.
Joan.
And she did it in the buck. She was a pretty fine babe in her time.
Fine babe.
Swing! 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 Excellent,
yeah.
Excellent. Double swing.
Swing.
Excellent.
Right. I got a funny feeling like when you climb a rope in gym class, you know?
You're such a putz.
Ugh.
Anyway, Paul Revere is actually the guy who makes those copper pans.
Copper pans? My mom had some of them. She was the most excellent cook.
Not! Remember the time she cooked those hard-boiled eggs and she burned them and she had to throw the pan away, but she still made you eat them?
Yeah,
I remember.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up, Wayne. Yeah, those eggs were so hideous, man. They were gonna make me hurl.
Take a Ritalin, Girth, will ya? If you hurl here, I'll blow chunks, and I don't like to spew on TV.
I'm not gonna spew, man. God.
Okay, anyway, it's time for the Wayne's World top 10 list for the
top
week.
Top 10! Wayne's World!
Wayne's World's top 10 softball plays of the year.
Yeah!
Wayne's World! Party time! Excellent!
Woo! Alright, okay. Yeah, here we go. I'm gonna start with number 10 with Bob Armstrong laying down the ground rules.
Let's go over the ground rules. You can't leave first until you chug a beer. Any man scoring has to chug a beer. You have to chug a beer at the top of all odd-numbered innings. Oh, and the fourth inning is the beer inning.
Hey, we know how to play softball.
Excellent. All right. You know, like, I really dig the Rudy Kazootie shorts that Bob showcases on the field.
Yeah, but where does he get that strike zone, man? It's like, it's diabolical. It's all over the place.
You know, I have to admit, Girth is right. I mean, if you're not careful at the plate, his strike zone will make you go mental.
Good
it's
call,
heinous.
Man. I know. But you know, if you give him a beer, he'll be making it to first base. No problemo.
No way.
Way.
No way.
Way.
Okay.
Okay,
on to the next play, number 9. Steve Joseph, foul ball ballet. Look at him track this ball down. He pirouettes like Gregory Hines in the movie White Knights.
Yeah, man. Wow, what an excellent landing. Not.
Okay, let's go to number 8. Chris Babbage, shoestring catch in the finals. Look at him go! The last time I saw Chris running that fast, his girlfriend was right behind him with a razor trying to shave his back.
No kidding, Wayne. He's got more hair than a multi grapefruit.
He's a Harrisaurus.
He's a hairaholic.
He's Bigfoot without the attitude.
Excellent. Great one. Okay,
bonus.
Man. Number 7. Smurfy Murphy spears a laser shot headed for Mr. Happy. That ball takes off so fast you can't even see it. And what reflexes by the Smurf man?
Yeah. Check this out in slow-mo. You can almost hear his goobers breathing a sigh of relief.
My unit hurts just watching it.
Yeah, take a break, Spichter boy. Get it under control. Okay, our next play is number 6. Dave Layden muffs Mike Elrod's cheesy fly ball. You know, Dave is usually an excellent fielder.
Yeah, but on this play, he looks like Gerald Ford. Hey, get on your feet, man.
Good call, Girth.
Cool.
You know, Smellrod probably called his parents at home and told him he hit a grand slam. He's such a tool sometimes.
Definitely a tool. All right, man. Now it's time for number 5. Chris Collins near fatal collision with Mouse Dog. What concentration? His sights are glued on that ball.
Whoa, look out for the Mouse Dog. Jeez, he almost trampled it.
Yeah, look at Chris trying to scare it. That mouse dog's not afraid of anything.
You know, Chris is lucky that mouse dog was on a leash, or he would have been dead meat.
No way. Chris could take it in a fair fight.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
And monkeys might fly out of my butt.
Good one, Wayne.
Okay, it's on to play number 4. Mike Ferrell tags Smurfy with a cool spin move at first.
Smurfy almost beats it out, but a heads-up play by Mike saves the day.
Good call, my friend. Okay, we're up to number 3.
Yeah, man, number 3. Don Hopkins' most excellent slide into home. Look at him motor down the baseline. What awesome spin! Not!
But Don makes a bonus move at the plate to slide in safe. This deserves a slow-mo shot. Okay, check out the move!
Awesome!
Excellent!
Awesome.
Alright, excellent!
Cool, yeah! Great move!
Right. Okay, we've reached number 2. This is where things really start getting serious. Not!
Not! Cool.
Okay. Here it is. Number 2. Steve Smith's home run to tie the league finals in the 7th inning. Hey, check it out. It's deep. It's gone.
Yeah, man. Get a load of Jeff Rudin. I haven't seen anyone eat as much of a treat as him since Yul Gibbons was doing Grape Nuts commercials. You know what I'm saying? Talk about pressure. I would have hurled.
Yeah, you totally. Know. Griff is right. I mean, coming up in the last inning needing 2 runs to tie a game, it's a lot of pressure. I would have blown chunks, too.
Definitely.
But spewing at the plate just isn't cool.
Oh, gross, man.
Yeah. Okay, so here we are. This is the moment everybody's been waiting for. The number 1 play of the year. Hey, chill, man. Chill. Just chill, Griff.
Sorry, I'm getting excited. This is a great shot.
What a tool. Okay, the number 1 play of the year is Rod Boggs' home run to win the league finals.
No doubt about this, Wayne. That ball is history.
Goodbye, Mr. Spaulding. Excellent shot, don't you think, Garth?
Oh, that was unbelievable.
I mean, undeniably gone.
What is it, like 12 feet over their head?
I don't know.
15? Very high.
Excellent. Okay, let's look at the replay on that championship swing.
Whoa, dig the jelly belly, man.
And for having the number 1 play of the season, we salute Mr. Boggs.
We're not worthy!
All right, excellent, cool. Well, right. We'll be right back with more Wayne's World after this commercial message from our sponsors.
Yeah, Wayne's World!
Yeah, Wayne's World! Excellent! Party time!
In the world of the professional athlete, you have to be able to count on your concentration as much as your skill in order to achieve your best. However, when that concentration is broken because of worrying about those uncontrollable bodily functions, the athlete breaks down and can't function, and it can cause some embarrassing moments. In this age of million-dollar contracts, it has always been hard for bodily dysfunctional athletes to earn the respect and the salaries that their counterparts do. That is until now. Depend Undergarments have developed a new and improved specially designed product for the active person, ProPens. These specially lined and sweat-resistant garments are made for the professional athlete. So get the undergarments the pros wear. ProPens. Strong, absorbent, and ProPen dependable. You can find ProPens in the Ego Trip department of your local supermarket.
Wayne's World, party time!
Party
excellent!
Up,
party time!
Woo!
Yeah, okay, hey, welcome back to Wayne's World. I'm your excellent host, Wayne Campbell. With me, as always, and even after commercials, is Gareth.
It's me. I'm
party
on.
Party on, Gareth.
Party on, Wayne.
Okay. Excellent. Cool. Great. Hey, you know, Gareth, I know you've always wanted to host this show.
That's right.
You can't because you're just not me.
I want to be.
You're not me.
I want to host the show, though.
You're just a tool. But I want to give you a taste of what it's like to host a show and be me.
To be you?
So...
No, I don't want to be you.
Well, sure you do.
All right, I'll try it. Yeah.
Okay, excellent bonus. All right, make him Gareth. I mean, make him me. You're me!
What?
You're you.
Don't you do that, man.
What's this?
Cut it out, I'm gonna hurt.
Video now. So we've got some softball awards we'd like to give away.
Sweet.
All right. So let's go to the softball awards now.
Let's check them out.
All right. Excellent bonus.
Excellent.
Excellent. All right. Wayne's World party time.
I was Wayne.
Bonus award.
The award for most inspirational pre-game pep talk goes to John Baker.
You ragtag bunch of misfits. You hate me, and I hate you even more. But without my beloved ringers, you're all I've got. So I want you to remember some inspiring things that someone else may have told you in the course of your lives, and go out there and win!
No, leave it on.
Now come the Fashion Plate Awards, and here's Wendell. Looks like he's wearing those pro pens, don't it?
Well, you know, he likes to have that comfortable feeling at the plate. Check out Wild Bill's shorts here. My God, he could fit a herd of cattle in there.
What's holding those things up anyway? I don't know. Where is his butt?
Check it out here. I don't know where his butt is. His butt is definitely lost in it. Let's get a close-up.
Holy
look at that.
Moly.
Jeez, get a belt, pal.
Our third fashion play goes to Brian Jensen.
Check it out. I look like I'm wearing a potato sack.
Holy cow. Those are baggier than I don't know what. Oh, don't get mad now.
But, you know, give credit to Murphy here, Mr. GQ.
Yeah.
He can't act like an athlete, but at least he tries to look like one.
Way to go, Murph.
Okay, now check this one out here. This one here is Duds in the background behind Dave Covino, flat out on his back. Duds picks up the Oscar for best performance in an injury situation. He took a knee to the head in the outfield and was basically playing it up. God, I mean, he's just really out of it here.
There he is now. Look, they're trying to lead him to the cooler with a beer. Come on, Duds, you can make it.
Duds?
Here, look, there's more inside. Come get one. Oh, he'll just take ice.
Duds did spend the night in the hospital, and he's recovering now, but he answers to the name Mary. Okay.
Oh.
Where is it? There it is. Here's Frank Giancora waiting for his chance at bat.
Yeah, the babes. Hello, girls. How you doing?
Good. Had to get the proverbial babe
shot. One more time.
Twice, yes. Of course, you see these two guys.
Yeah, we're on you, pal.
Yeah, we caught him.
Relax.
And we had to get James in there. James ranked on us last year for not getting him in. Here he is now. Here's Randy.
Yeah, Randy. Look
go
at
ahead.
His swing. Watch this, everyone. All the power he got. Oh,
he's out of there. He's real happy about that one.
I remember when I took my first swing at the plate, and here's Chris Collins following suit.
Nice pitch by Don Hopkin there. He thinks he's at the bowling alley.
Unbelievable.
Of course, Ramo probably wishes he was at the bowling alley on this one. Nice catch, pal.
How many people does it take to catch a fly ball? I don't know.
There's a swing by Owen Stoddard up the middle.
And watch Murph come around third. Look at that speed. He's unbelievable. And here comes the balance play.
Oh.
I hate when I get old. And here's Rudlow with a nice shot.
Hey, he shows he can still hit even at his age.
Yeah. What are those things bouncing anyway?
Of course, you can see the uniform doesn't help you.
Hey, but you look good, Brian. That's all that matters.
Well, it's better to look good than to feel good.
And here's Bob Cipolla looking for gold. I don't know. Did he find any yet?
Is that Bob or his brother?
Who is that guy? And here's Chuck Sear. I think he gets one out of the ballpark on this one.
Yeah, Chuck Sear really gets around on this shot and just barely gets it out of the park.
I think that bounced in, Brian. I don't know.
Well, nobody contested. They gave him the homer.
All right.
I wish he'd run a little faster, though. We got more clips to show
you. Yeah, you know, we don't have all day.
Look, even the camera's ahead of him. The camera's faster than him. Come on, where are you, Chuck? There he is. And here's the whole league became concerned when Bob Armstrong started petting imaginary dogs at the plate.
What is he doing?
That explains the strike zone, I guess.
And here's Mike Elrod at the plate. Mike is always good for a crushing blow.
He really tanked one here. I mean, just look at this ball all the way out to the fence at Holy Cross.
Holy Holy cow, the fans must be going crazy by now. What do you think, Brian? Look at this, sending them in. What a play. Walks in uncontested.
The fans were jumping, all except for his son, Jason. I guess he can really care less right now. Where's the bottle? Where's my bottle? There's a nifty play by Murph.
Look at this play in Collins.
Oh, they almost had Collins. He's off the base.
Oh, my God, they got him in a rundown. Here's the play. He's all right.
He's safe. Incredible.
Hey, Chris, you better stick to law. Man, what do we have here?
We got it's Baker getting a hit, and...
Who's that guy right there? Who is that masked man?
What blazing speed!
Oh, my God, that's Brian Jensen!
Watch out, here comes... Look out! Oh, almost gets hit in the head.
Unbelievable.
It would have helped.
Hey, Bob, did you find that gold yet? Is that Bob or not?
He's still looking.
Oh, and here's a line drive out the right field.
Jake Kirk comes up.
Look at that arm, ladies and gentlemen.
Woo! Oh, and the fans are cheering heartily.
Hey, Frank, that's a great... Yeah, it's unbelievable, huh?
Of course, Frank acknowledges the fans in his usual way.
Wow. Boy, is that Jose Canseco at Fenway Park? I don't know.
There's a shot up through the right side there. Perez gets on. What the hell is this? Perez gets a muscle spasm after throwing that one. And
what is that anyway, Brian?
I don't know. I think he's lost control of his arm.
I'm kind
of
concerned here.
Call a medic.
We better stop this right now. I think it's a little bit too... I don't want to say... Well, all right, I'll say it. No, I won't say it. I won't. And here's Frank Jancor.
Jancor comes through again with the hit.
Holy cow, look at this blazing speed. Where's he going? Here comes the play. The play's going to be close. Oh, where is the ball?
He's in there. The ball gets by Dave Martin.
Where is the ball? And there we go. Run to the third. And Frank pulls up with a
double.
Frank's
on second. Hey, let's see that hooting and hollering out there. He's even got the arm problems.
What is this? The whole team must have a problem like that. And here's Randy Schumann again. Another line shot.
Randy keeps it fair, but Frank catches it. Another line shot to the plate.
Wow.
What a bullseye.
He is incredible, huh?
He's on the mark here. And Baker makes a sensational catch on a line drive.
Woo!
A sure base hit.
Piece of cake, he says, and he just throws the ball down in disgust. Oh, good play.
Yeah, Wild Bill puts it through Jay's legs. Oh, but he gets caught in a pickle here.
Here we go.
They got him.
Dive for first.
Oh, Jay makes up for it, gets him out.
You got to be a little bit closer to first next time.
Well,
okay,
the run scored on the play.
Whoa.
What form by Jim Jackson on that hit. Will Baker make the play here?
Baker, another one. No problem.
Oh, it's just by him.
Just out of his reach.
Baker gets the miss. Jackson gets the hit.
Hey, Bob, where's that gold anyway? Oh, my God.
He found something. Maybe booger nuggets.
Booger nuggets? I hate those things.
Murph puts one down the line. Perez comes up.
Watch this scoop, ladies and gentlemen. Watch this scoop. Ready?
Incredible goal. It's a score.
And here we go. The Fashion Plate Award.
Yep.
And it's a shot. It's a deep drive.
Golden Boy's really spinning out here. Look at him taking off for first.
What speed on this gentleman.
Legging out that single. Incredible. Incredible effort. Matt Brown comes through with his base hit. The typical base hit for Matt. And Jim Jackson easily scores.
Look at that form Rich Jordan has. He is unbelievable.
I'll tell you, Paul Taylor admires it too. Get out of the picture.
Jesus.
Pops the pole, hits one up the middle. It's a shot.
Jordan. Rich makes it look easy, don't he?
Impressive, impressive.
Those depends do it every time.
I'm telling you. And here's something you don't see every day. Rich Jordan hitting the big home run.
No way. I don't believe it.
Look at him. He's still going.
I don't believe it.
He's at third. He's going. He's going for
no
the play.
Way.
He's
Whoa.
There. And he's
Homer.
Still going. Come on back, Rich.
I think he went home after that.
I think so.
Oh, man, with a line drive off the middle. Oh, no. Nice play. Mr. Perez.
Rick Perez comes up with a nice shot there.
Any arm jerk on this one? No.
And of course, I think Bob's still out in the field.
Excellent plays, Mike.
For sure.
Wow.
All right, bonus. Well, hey, those are all the plays we got for this year. And, you know, the Port Revere Softball League had a pretty good season.
They sure did. I mean, the men's team was unbelievable.
Not! They didn't even have a team.
They didn't have one.
They didn't have a team. Where was Dombowski? You know, this John Dombowski was running the team. He's gone. He took up.
I don't know. What?
Yeah.
Well, anyway.
Okay, well, anyway, that's all we got for this year. We hope to see you again next year, man.
Yeah, definitely. Cool. And remember, party!
Party! Bloopers right after this, man.
Don't go away.
Party!
go down the street.